This is the actor Samuel L. Jackson. Jackson has played a number of strong and determined characters in films over the years. For example, he's been Nick Fury in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, he's been a Jedi Knight in Star Wars, and he's also been a hitman in Quentin Tarantino's Pulp Fiction. But Jackson has also played a number of characters who have some fragility associated with them, for example, due to a past experience or a health condition. One prime example is Elijah Price from the 2000 film Unbreakable. In the film, two characters are primarily featured with contrasting health conditions. In one scene, Elijah Price explains his condition to the other major character in the film, David Dunn, played by Bruce Willis. David Dunn has never broken a bone in his body. He is effectively unbreakable. But Elijah Price only knows broken bones. For you see, Elijah Price has osteogenesis imperfecta. Osteogenesis imperfecta, or brittle bone disease, is a genetic disorder that is caused by either a genetic mutation or it can be inherited from someone's parents. And there are many different versions or types of the condition. In Unbreakable, Elijah Price has type 1 osteogenesis imperfecta, which is the mildest form of the condition. Now, the most common versions of this condition are typically caused by mutations to genes associated with the production of collagen. Collagen is a protein you'll find all over your body. It's in your ligaments, it's in your tendons, it's in your skin, and it's in your bones. And it's really important for your bones to have lots of viable collagen in order to increase and have good bone mineral density. But there are other symptoms associated with the condition of osteogenesis imperfecta. Somebody might have loose joints, they could have hearing loss, and they could also have a blue tinge in the white of their eyes. Unfortunately, there is no cure for osteogenesis imperfecta. That doesn't mean the condition can't be treated, though, in some way. In the film Unbreakable, Elijah Price suffers a serious fall and a number of fractures to his leg. The doctor, who decides to work on him and give him the treatment that he needs, informs Elijah Price that they're going to implant some metal rods to provide structural support for his bones as they heal. And in the real world, this is a normal way of treating this condition, particularly if someone breaks their bones. However, how can Elijah Price take ownership of his condition, or anyone else with osteogenesis imperfecta? How can they manage it and how can they help themselves? Well, one way to do this is through proper nutritional intervention. It's well documented that calcium in the diet can help with bone mineral density and bone health. In a 2019 study in Brazil, a number of researchers designed a nutritional intervention for pediatric patients with osteogenesis imperfecta. The patients followed the plan for 1 year, and afterwards the researchers assessed the bone mineral density and other aspects of the patients. They found that the patients who strictly followed the intervention showed better bone mineral density than before the intervention, which is a very good thing. Now, perhaps these patients would like to know how effective this intervention was during the actual research itself. One way to do this might be to use biosensors. Unfortunately, researchers out there are developing biosensors. Biosensors can look for particular molecules of interest in the body, and a biosensor for bone growth would be looking for particular molecules that are being produced in the body that might signal healthy bone growth. And perhaps it could be worn on the body in the future in much the same way that the continuous glucose monitoring devices are worn by people with diabetes. Evidently, osteogenesis imperfecta affects the lives of many people who have the condition in many different ways. But it also affects the lives of the caregivers and the family members who are looking after those with the condition. Fortunately, there are a number of organizations out there that strive to provide support and resources for those who are dealing with the condition, as well as providing support to those with the condition. One such organization is the Osteogenesis Imperfecta Foundation. Now, it's great to have medical treatments, self-monitoring devices, nutritional interventions, and societal support, and all of this helps those with osteogenesis imperfecta. But it goes without saying that we need more research and development in the area. The motto of the Osteogenesis Imperfecta Foundation is Unbreakable Spirit, and this is something I think that Elijah Price can certainly relate to. And moving forward into the future, I'm sure that that spirit will remain unbreakable.